New children.
Children. Up to page number 13, we have completed our textbook exercise. Okay. Now, you can open page number 31 to see next textbook exercise. Here, it is sentences and questions. So I am going to read from book and then I will explain you. If you have book, you can open it. See, a sentence is a group of words that tells us a complete thought. For example, Arun wanted to make her smile. He took out something from his bag. Okay. This is a sentence. How you can say that this is a sentence? Because it gives us a complete meaning, a complete sense of this sentence. You can understand something is correct. Okay. That is sentence. The first and you can also identify sentence from its first letter and at last, there should be a full stop. Okay. See, Arun wanted to make her smile. Here, Arun is A is capital and after smile, there is full stop. Okay. Next is, a question is a sentence that asks for information. For example, are you feeling okay? The teacher asked her now. That are you feeling okay? In this, there is lagging of any information that person wants to know from someone, and that's why that person is asking that question. That is question. Okay. Whenever there is no any information, that is question. Okay. Generally, questions begin with do. Then is the answer may be yes and no. See, if a question starts with are, is, do or does, the answer is usually yes or no. Simply you have to say yes or no. In this way, is your little brother okay? So that Shanti only nodded her head to say yes or no. If I may ask you, are you not feeling well? So you should only reply yes or no. Okay. So now see, question A, on basis of this, put the word in the correct order to make a sentence. In this question, the words are not kept in correct order. So, we have to arrange them to make our meaningful sentence. See, give, I, her, got, her. You can't understand anything from this, and that's why it is not correct sentence. Though, at the end of sentence, there is only full stop, and in the beginning, there is no capital letter. So, it is not correct sentence. So, what we can do to make it correct and meaningful sentence? See, if any word is given to you in this capital, yes, so we selected this I. Okay, so right here I. That is subject. Okay. Who gave? I gave. So I is subject, so you can write here I. Then you should select here verb. What is the verb? Give. Give means dena, that is the verb, and that's why you can write here give, I give. What you give? A pot. Pot is a pot is object. So you can write here object, but here there is more information, that is to her. So who did I give that pot? To her, and that's why before that object you have write her. Okay. I gave her a pot. there good is given to you in more information. It is quality of your frame, and that's why if you put that frame, you can write that a good frame. Then it will become meaningful and complete sentence. It is Sarla is a good frame. In sentence, you should write, you should select first subject. That means a person who is doing any action. Then after that you can select the verb, that means doing word, that which action that person is giving. Okay. Then object. Okay. With whom that activity or activity is doing. Then the if there is more information, you can arrange that before that. Object. Understood? Next, see, we have seen that if the question begins with do, does, is, are, and, the, that the answer is simply yes or no. So here the question is, actually answer is given to you and you have to make questions. So your answer is yes, he is angry. So how you can make question from that? He is angry. So answer is yes. So you can do this answer now. He is angry. So it is simply sentence. So we have to make that in question form. So first you can take that verb, that is. So is he angry? And at the end of sentence you can put question mark. Then it will become a correct question. Next, do you? Answer is no. I don't play cricket. That means he don't like to play cricket. Okay. So how you? So this you can remove this because it is answer. We want to make question form. So I don't play cricket. So I is subject. So don't play cricket. So don't is verb. So take first this and do you. Do you play cricket? Okay. Do you play cricket? So he replies, no, I don't play cricket. Maybe he play any other game or not. Okay. So only two examples I have given here. Remaining I am ready. Fly boards, the sky, the in. The answer is the birds fly in the sky. Tiger wants to he see a. So he wants to see a tiger. Okay. Next. Page number 32. Are they friends? Yes, they are friends. Are they dancing? No, they are not dancing. Okay, children. Now next topic is pronouns. So children, what do you mean by pronouns? Pronouns is a word that we utilize in sentence instead of noun. If I want to say that Ram is very good boy, Ram is very obedient boy, then instead of Ram in sentence again and again, what I can say? That pronouns. If Ram is a boy, then I can use the he. Ram is very good boy and he is an obedient child. Okay. So see first, I am reading from book. See, Shanti and Arun were best friends. Shanti and Arun had a lot of fun together. Shanti and Arun shared secrets in class. Shanti and Arun ran races on their way home. So here again and again, seeing Shanti and Arun, Shanti and Arun, we can use pronouns instead of that. The names Shanti and Arun are repeated in all sentences. It does not sound good. Now to read
the text again. Okay, now read the text again. Shanti and Arun were best friends. They had a lot of fun. Here instead of Shanti and Arun, see what we used, they. Why we used they, I will explain you later. They shared secrets in the class. They ran races on their way home. Then, the noun Shanti and Arun have been replaced by they. Words that replace nouns are called pronouns. Understood that I explained you. The word that we use instead of any noun, that is called pronouns. Okay, next. Here are some pronouns. In this column, singular and plural pronouns we have two. So we can read in singular pronoun, I, you, he, she, it. For example, I like listening to music, you like to play the piano, and he is playing with a ball, and she is a good singer, and it is a beautiful house. The next in plural, we, they, you. For example, we like to play tennis, they like to dance, and you will get a prize. Okay, next. The pronoun is used for animals and things. For example, I saw a monkey. It was eating bananas. Now children, see, on blackboard I am going to explain you. The word that we changed and we used instead of noun. So, but how we can change that word? How we can utilize the particular proper and particular word for that noun? See, if there is a noun, that is female. If there is Sita, Sita is a girl. So for girl we can use she. Okay. In this way, Shanti and Arun. Shanti is a good friend of Arun. Shanti played with Arun. Shanti. So Shanti is a girl. And instead of that girl, instead of that name Shanti, we can use she. Understood? Then for boy, if I want to say Ram, just I explain you, Ram is a good boy, Ram is an obedient child, Ram is. So and so and so blah blah blah. So instead of using that Ram again and again, if Ram is a boy, we can use he. Okay. So now I can construct sentences in this way. Ram is a good boy and Ram is an obedient child in my class. Understood? So instead of ball, we can use here he. Next is animals. For animals, for example, dog, cat, buffalo, cow, ox, we can use it. Cow is an animal. So instead of that, it is a pet animal and it gives milk. Okay. So for animals, we can use he. We can use it. Next, for non-living things also. For example, I have book. So what I can use? I have book and it is very colorful. Okay, it has so many pictures. Understood? That means my book is very colorful because as it is non-living thing, we can write there it instead of the book. The next is for plural. If I want to say about they, then what I can use? For 2-3 boys or for 2-3 girls or maybe for 2 girls and 2 boys. In plural, it doesn't matter whether they are female or male. Okay. In group they are, then they are they. They are plural. For plural, in for example, for objects also. If I have 2-3 books, then I can say they. Okay. They are very beautiful. They are very beautiful. The same way, when there are 2 children and I is added, I am with them, then what I can say? Not only 2, but if there is a single boy or girl also, and if I am with that girl or boy, then it will become we. जब हम किसी के साथ होते हैं तो that becomes we. Understood? It becomes we. When I is added, it becomes we. And if I am not there, but 2 girls or 2 boys are there, then they are they. For them, I can use they. Okay? on the basis of that I will explain you our next exercise. Rohan is flying a kite. So instead of Rohan we can use here he is flying a kite. Then children like to play. Children means plural, so they like to play. Here grandfather wakes up early, so grandfather is a boy, so we can say he wakes up early. Next, bottles are usually made of glass or plastic. Bottles are in plural form and they are non-living, so we can say they are usually made of glass or plastic. Then Parul and Tina are going to school. They are going to school. Parul and Tina are two girls. Okay, then next, this is Tabby is a cute cat. And Tabby is a, when you know that that is a female or male, you can use that he or she there in case of animals also. So here Tabby is a female, so we can use here she. She loves to drink milk. Then my friend and I love football. I explained that if I am added to anyone, then that is we. So here we play football every day. Okay children, so children, see you soon. Bye. In next period we will see our page number 34. Okay.